Hello everyone, welcome to the presentation. Today we are going to discuss about bacterial conjugation. Bacterial conjugation is the transfer of genetic information by direct cell-to-cell contact. The initial evidence of bacterial conjugation came from the experiments performed by Joshua Lederberg and Edward L. Tatum in 1946. In that experiment, they mixed two auxotrophic strains, incubated culture for several hours in nutrient media, and then plated it on minimal medium. So that was the experiment they performed. Later in 1950, Bernard Davis, from his YouTube experiment, provided the evidence of physical contact of the cells was necessary for gene transfer. So let us see what is the YouTube experiment. In this experiment, a YouTube consisting of two pieces of curved glass tubing fused at the base to form U-shape with a fritted glass filter between the halves was prepared or constructed. The filter allows the passage of media but not bacteria. The U-tube was filled with nutrient media and each side inoculated with different auxotrophic strains of E. coli. During incubation, the medium was pumped back and forth through the filter to ensure media exchange between the halves. After 4 hours of incubation, the bacteria were plated on minimal medium. Davis discovered that when two auxotrophic strains were separated from each other by a fine filter, gene transfer could not take place. Therefore, direct contact was required for the recombination that Lederberg and Tatum has observed. So, this was his experiment to prove that physical contact was required for the gene transfer. Bacterial conjugation occurs in three different ways. One is F plus F minus mating, HFR conjugation, and F dash conjugation. So let us see one by one in detail. F plus F minus mating. In 1952, William Hayes demonstrated that gene transfer observed by Lederberg and Tatum was polar. That is, there were definite donor, that is F plus and recipient strains F minus, and gene transfer was non-reciprocal. He also found that F plus F minus mating, the progeny were only rarely changed with regard to auxotrophy, but F minus strains frequency become F plus. The F plus strain contains an extra chromosomal F factor carrying the genes for pilus formation and the plasmid transfer. During F plus F minus mating or conjugation, the F factor replicates by the rolling circle mechanism and a copy moves to the recipient. The entering strand is copied to produce double-stranded DNA. Because the bacterial chromosome genes are rarely transferred with the independent F factor, the recombination frequency is low. The 6 pilus or F pilus joins the donor and recipient and may contract to draw them together. The channel for DNA transfer could be either a hollow F pilus or a special conjugation bridge formed upon contact. Although most research on plasmids and conjugation has been done using E. coli and other gram-negative bacteria, self-transmissible plasmids are present in gram-positive bacteria genera such as Bacillus, Streptococcus, Enterococcus, Staphylococcus and Streptomyces. It appears that fewer transfer genes are involved, possibly because a sex pilus does not seem to be required for plasmid transfer. Let us see what is HFR conjugation. HFR conjugation stands for high frequency conjugation. The plasmid can directly synthesize the pili, carry out rolling cycle replication and transfer genetic material to the F minus recipient cell. Such donor is called as HFR strain, because it exhibits a very high efficiency of chromosomal gene transfer in comparison with F plus cells. DNA transfer begins when the integrated F factor is nicked at its site of transfer of origin. As it is replicated, the chromosome moves through the pilus or conjugation bridge connecting the donor and recipient. Because only part of the F factor is transferred at the start, the F minus recipient does not become F plus unless the whole chromosome is transferred. Transfer is standard at 100 minutes in E. coli and the connection usually breaks before the process is finished. Thus, a complete F factor usually is not transferred and the recipient remains F minus. As mentioned earlier, when an HFR strain participates in conjugation, bacterial genes are frequently transferred to the recipient cell. Gene transfer can be either in clockwise or counterclockwise clockwise direction around the circular chromosome, depending on the orientation of integrated F factor. After the replicated donor chromosome enters the recipient cell, it may be degraded or incorporated into the F minus genome by recombination. Let us see what is F dash conjugation. Because the F plasmid is an episome, it can leave the bacterial chromosome. Sometimes during this process, plasmid makes an error in excision and picks up portion of chromosomal material to from F dash plasmid. It is not unusual to observe the inclusion of one or more genes in the excised F plasmid. The F dash cell retains all its genes, although some of them are on the plasmid, and still mates only with an F minus, recipient. The F dash F minus conjugation is virtually identical with F plus F minus mating. Once again, the plasmid is transferred, but usually bacterial genes on the chromosome are not. Bacterial genes on the F dash plasmid are transferred with it and need not be incorporated into the recipient chromosome to be expressed. In this way, a specific bacterial gene may spread rapidly throughout the bacterial population. Such transfer of bacterial gene is often called as sexduction. So these are the basics of conjugation. Hope it is clear now. If you like the video, please like and subscribe. Thank you.